All aboard the Woolly Bear Express, stopping in Vermilion, Ohio. Your fast track to family-friendly entertainment.
It's free and it's just fun. You got to admit that.
A lively event celebrating all living creatures, big, small, scooting, slithering, swinging, and of course, crawling. From these youngsters at the YMCA's kids race.
Go! We're good.
To dozens of fuzzy worms competing in the Woolly Bear 500.
What's his name?
Poopy Bear.
Say it again.
Poopy Bear.
Why do you call him Poopy Bear?
Because he poops a lot.
But can he slink into first place?
Don't let him spin out.
Go, 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 go.
Lane three, lane one.
Are you ready for the race?
Yeah.
This crazy caterpillar extravaganza started as a small PTA fundraiser in 1973, but has become the largest one-day event in Ohio.
Go ahead and pat him, isn't he gorgeous?
How long have you been coming to the event?
Oh, quite a while, maybe 10 years.
This is my first time being here.
Over 100,000 people enjoying a multitude of activities and an array of heavenly foods.
What's your favorite?
The French fries.
And the fact that it's grown so much and people keep showing up, over 100,000 people at least a year, is pretty amazing.
Kim should know. Her dad is Fox 8's Dick Goddard.
Oh, you look like a bug in a rug, huh?
Founding father of the Woolly Bear, with countless fond and funny memories.
We had one band that just came in unannounced, but the problem was there. They had to be at the very end of the parade, and they marched behind the horse units, which meant, luckily, it was a high-stepping group.
Yeah, and he's going after your neck.
Oh, he is? Uh-oh.
Hey, two, the winner!
Like about it.
Oh, you get to see all the Goddard and Big Chuck and Little John. That's the greatest.
The big dogs. They have the biggest, beautiful dogs out here.
This is the 42nd year for the Woolly Bear Festival and Parade, but these caterpillars have been predicting the weather since colonial days. As legend goes, the wider the brown stripe, the more mild the winter. What do you think, Gianna?
Mild.
That's a cutie.
Looking at just that one woolly bear, though, what's your professional opinion about our winter? Can we say?
Well, we have to wait till we see all the caterpillars. You can't just judge winter on one caterpillar.
No problem. There were plenty more crawlers everywhere Sunday. Plus some imposters in the pet competition.
Hi. What's her name?
Tater Tot.
She definitely fit better yesterday. Oh.
The human animal costume judging.
From dainty designs to full-on fur. The only thing cuter than the costumes were the children wearing them.
Is it pretty? Is it fun? What is it?
Pretty.
It's all homemade. I just grabbed some tooling and some nylons and pipe cleaners and hot glue.
So it's couture.
Yeah, it's totally couture.
A slice of Americana that Fox 8 gladly supports each year, with all of your on-air friends stopping by for autographs, handshakes, and the occasional hug.
How you doing?
And that's what Dick Goddard is most proud of. Despite the event's continued growth, there's never been a problem.
It's a wonderful band, including the Vermilion Sailor.
Happy Woolly Bear Day!
He says this parade and festival remains a safe harbor for a good, clean, neighborly afternoon.
This theme again is be kind to all animals. Not only the 4-foot, but the 2-footed animals.
In Vermilion, Suzanne Stratford, Fox 8 News.